Ladies and gentlemen, how's it going? Once again, I'm Nev from Nev's Tech Bits, and today I'm going to show you how to troubleshoot a Lenovo laptop that won't turn on. Alright, so the first step you always have to take is pull the battery and pull the power, leave it for a minute, turn it on, and see if it works. If that doesn't work, the next thing you got to try is the power button. Press and hold the power button down for 10 seconds, or maybe it's 30. Try 30 seconds, and then tap it on one more time to see if that works. That never works for me, but Lenovo always tells me to try that. When that doesn't work, there is one more step at the back, actually. So newer Lenovo models, at least for this timeline, have a little hole in the bottom that you have to prick in order to reset the CMOS. And I gotta tell you, these particular systems with these reset buttons have a habit of killing themselves, more or less. You see what happens is people close them up, the battery goes dead, and then you can't turn them back on even after you get the battery charged again. It sucks, but you gotta find that pinhole. Sometimes they're in the right or the left side. They look like a microphone pinhole. And again, in these situations, you just gotta get some kind of a pin, a paperclip, press and hold for about 30 seconds, and then you should be able to turn it on. That was the big thing. That was the big issue that we kept running into. People going out to the Far East, and they're not turning their systems off. They're just closing it, and then when they go to turn the power back on, it doesn't start up. You expect some people to do this. You know what your end users are going to do. You know what they're capable of. You know what they're going to be doing, and that is the basics. Now we're going to get into a little bit more complicated stuff here. But remember, try unplugging it, unplugging all the power, and try that CMOS. Once again, the CMOS battery reset is here on the bottom of my unit, but it's probably on the right or left side of yours. Not all systems have it, but if they do, you'll definitely need to use this method. It definitely works, and it definitely saved me some issues. Now, we might have to go one step further, and I have had to go one step further. And this might not be for all y'all, but if you got the stomach for it, or if you got some family that's inclined enough, this might work. And on a lot of systems, you have to actually just get into it and disconnect the main power. So in this system, there is no detachable battery. The battery's on the inside, and the battery for the CMOS or the BIOS chip is actually inside. So you got to get into it, and you got to disconnect the CMOS battery and the standard battery in order to do a motherboard reboot. It's unfortunate, but that's just how it goes. Now, with most Lenovos, you got your screws, and then you got clips. So take a look at where the screws are, and know you got to deal with the clips. Manufacturers love putting clips onto everything. So get an idea and get a spudger. Definitely get a spudger. And man, it's hard to get these things off sometimes, but it definitely can be done. So take the top off and then just disconnect the power. So you get the battery. That's the CMOS battery. You just pull it out, leave it for about a minute, and plug it back in. Same with that battery. It connects in two different places, I believe. Just one. Anyways, just disconnect those, plug them back in, and away you go. Now, if that doesn't work, then the next thing you need to do is start removing things like the hard drive and the RAM while the thing's powered off, of course. And then when you do that, once you turn the power on, you should be hearing beeping or something. The motherboard should be complaining that it's not turning on. Now, if you get beep codes, that means that certain issues are going on. If you get certain beep codes, like generally I think it's 4 beeps on an old HP DC5750, that means that you got some bad RAM. Other beeps could mean you have a bad power supply. So if you get beep codes, make sure you look them up. 3 beeps, three short beeps, one long beep, that kind of thing. And put it into Google and it'll tell you what's going on. But if these instructions haven't been able to help you, then odds are you have to take your computer into a repairman. You might have some pretty serious problems. But good luck, folks. Take care of each other. Have a good one.